Hey guys, so that time of the month again where I do my take of a meta-analysis where based on the top 25 ranked players on Dueling Book, I use YGOscope.com to find their 20 most recent replays and outline what decks they were playing and their win percentage based on different factors. And if you want monthly meta-analyses like these, then make sure to subscribe. So let's just get started. So this time around in May, I had 496 matches included, where I had to exclude a few matches because they concluded before any card was played, so you can roughly attribute 20 matches to the same player. So Dragonlink, Prank Kids, and Dogmatica Invoke Shadol are still the 3 most played decks among the top players, something you saw in my last month's meta-analysis. But we actually see some Infernal Noble Knight as well, which was one of the most played rogue decks among the top 100 ranked players in my most recent rogue analysis that you can watch. And then we have some Eldritch variants that I clumped together, and this includes Dogmatica Eldritch, Invoked Eldritch, and Eldritch Dragoon. Then we had 20 matches contributed from a variety of decks, ABC, Madolche, Orcus, which was actually the top ranked player at the time that I collected my data for this video. Interesting to see that Tri-Brigade did not have as much of a showing among the top 25 players, because I know I have been seeing this a lot on Dueling Book. You have other decks like Subterror, Virtual World, and Zodiac, whether pure or Eldritch. I clumped the decks with less than 4% together, and this included decks like Drytron, Dinosaur, and Necroz. Speaking of dinosaurs, I was surprised to see almost zero representation from this deck among the top 25 players, since if you look at YGOscope, it is actually the most played deck on Dueling Book for the current format among all players. You can see that Tri-Brigade is also played quite a lot overall online, but not too much among our top 25 players. Lastly, we saw that about 20% of the matches played by top players involved a Dogmatica engine in their decks, and 11% included an Eldritch engine. Last month, only about 4% of the matches involved an Eldritch engine, so we saw a bit of a bump this month. So I'll just show you a quick glimpse of my last month's meta-analysis pie chart, and it looks pretty much the same as this month. It was done a few weeks ago after all, but considering that our next ban list is not until July 1st at the earliest, I think this is kind of the format that we have to get used to, although perhaps Drytron will make a comeback after Mew Beta gets released in a month. So overall, our top 25 players won 74% of their matches, and if you keep up with my meta-analysis, you'll know that this is the sweet spot number, and it always ends up hovering around here. In terms of playstyle, we had about 66% of matches among our top players that involved a combo-oriented aggro style like Dragonlink and Prank Kids, which is a bit higher from 59% from last month. Control strategies like Dogmatica Invoke, Shadol, Subterror, and Eldritch variants made up 34%, similar to last month. Beatdown strategies that involve your typical break my board kind of decks were an all-time low at 0.2%, considering that we practically had no dinos or mech knights and stuff like that among our top players. So when our top 25 players won the die roll, they chose to go first for game 1 93% of the time. So in my last month's meta-analysis, this value was around 87%, so we had more going first strategies this time around. Alternatively, when our top 25 players lost the die roll, they still got to go first for game 1 about 11% of the time. Compare that to about 17% in my last month's meta-analysis, so it's dropped a bit, so perhaps going second strategies are being played a bit less now, or maybe it's just due to the relatively small sample size. Now let's cover some of the most played decks in more detail. Dragonlink won 82% of their matches, which is pretty insane, and up from 75% in my last month's meta-analysis. They can just play through a variety of different interruptions, and it just always seems like they have extender after extender, and their end board of Seal, Savage, and Tidying along with the Levy hand rip may perhaps not be as intimidating as their old Buster Lock board, but the grind game of this deck is now very, very good. When they got to go first for game 1, they ended up winning 91% of the matches, which is absolutely ridiculous, and their win percentage when going first just seems to climb up as time goes by. Even when they had to go second for game 1, they still ended up winning 72% of their matches. Despite being a combo deck, they have decent room for hand traps, so they still have the capability of slowing you down even if they have to go second. In terms of their win percentage versus different playstyles, very balanced and also really high at 79-93%, and looks pretty much in line with my last month's meta-analysis as well. Next up, we have Prank Kids. After VFD was stowed away, I think this deck has really been able to shine, and the Link 1 Meow Meow Mew really makes this deck insanely consistent. They won about 70% of the matches this time around, and when they got to go first for game 1, they won 70% of the time, and 69% of the time if they have to go second for game 1. Basically, dead even this time around, even though last month they actually had a much bigger gap if they went first versus second for game 1. Probably due to the small sample size where there is a lot of variance, but perhaps something just clicked with this deck and they are able to play better even if they lose the die roll for at least this month. As for win percentage against different playstyles, pretty balanced this month at around 68-75%. Last month they struggled a lot against other aggro strategies, but now it's pretty respectable at 70%. Again, very small sample size we are talking about here, but I find they do usually line up pretty well each month and are generally consistent. At third, we have Dogmatica Invoke Shadal, really one of the best control decks we have out right now, where Mechaba and Windup plus another trap or hand trap can really make it hard to get past this deck. It won about 70% of the matches this time around, a bit lower than the 78% we saw in my last month's meta-analysis. If they went first for game 1, they won about 77% of the matches, whereas they won 60% if they went second. This is certainly different than last time, where Dogmatica and Invoke Shadal typically had a good balanced win-loss percentage whether they went first or second for game 1. Again, small sample size, but perhaps our Dogmatica and Invoke players also had a bad day this time around. As for win percentage against different playstyles, it was balanced against control and beatdown strategies at 79-80%, but really struggled against aggro strategies this month at 42%. In the past, this deck had a really balanced and strong performance against these three playstyles, but again, really small sample size that we are dealing with, so the numbers can vary widely at times. So if the top players playing this deck just happen to have a rough stretch of games at the time that I collected the data, it can have a big influence. Finally, we are going to cover Infernoble Knights. I'm not going to cover Eldritch Variants because they are a combination of different decks, so I don't think it would be appropriate to combine them for this kind of analysis. Anyways, Infernoble Knights won about 72% of the matches, and considering that they are far from the hand-ripping machine that they once were, I think this is quite impressive. If they got to go first for game 1, they won about 77% of the matches, while winning 62% of the matches if they had to go second for game 1. They can still do a small amount of hand ripping with Aqua Dolphin, and just being a combo deck, it can set up at least a Herald and Charles with its quick effect pop, so it's still pretty respectable to have to go through. As for win percentage against different playstyles, quite balanced as well between 67-77% against the three strategies, and something you may have seen already in my most recent Rogue analysis that featured Infernoble Knights. Alright guys, so that was it for this month's meta-analysis. Almost the same as last month's basically, so hopefully the release of Lightning Overdrive will bring us some more diversity in the format since the next banlist is still a bit away. Again, if you want to see monthly meta-analysis like these, then make sure to subscribe. Take care guys.